And if you take from the hand of the receiver this line here, from these four fingers, is equal to three tsuns, which in the receiver, then you calculate three tsuns from the umbilicus down. And here there is a very important point called conception vessel 4, which greatly helps the small intestine, digestion, and particularly assimilation. In Chinese medicine, thousands of years ago, before knowing the scientific roots of the physiology of the organs, they used to call the small intestine the judge. Why? Because they say it separates the pure from the impure. And that's what it does, in the sense that it absorbs vitamins and nutrients and recycles into the large intestine that which is not needed anymore by the body. Okay? If we take from the umbilicus two tsuns, which again, you take the middle phalanx, the space between the two creases, okay? One tsun, so take one tsun, one tsun. So two tsuns from each side of the abdomen. You have spleen 15, stomach 25, forgive me. Very good point for digestion. Now, if you want to learn in detail more these abdominal points, you can search stomach 25 or ST25, and one of my clips will come up where I describe quite in detail this abdominal point. If you go a further two tsuns here, you reach spleen 15. Very, very good point for constipation. So, of course, if the client needs it, you stay much longer on those points. One last point that I'd like to mention is if you take the tip of the sternum and the navel, the umbilicus, exactly halfway between the two, you have conception vessel 12, which is very good for the digestion in the stomach. It really helps the function of the stomach. And of course, there are people normally, lay people, very often, at least here in the UK, when they say stomach, they mean abdomen. But I am really mean stomach, not the all the area of the abdomen, but I'm meaning the organ in the upper abdomen, which is the stomach. So again, you can do CV12 to help this area. Again, you can stay longer if the client requires it. And again, then we finish all this routine with some nice soothing effleurage and rubbing movements. You can also do a little variation, which it's normally quite well received. Then generic effleurage. Now, I also like to mention, you know, this nice movement massage that we do all over the large intestine, okay? Ascending, transverse, descending. you can instruct the client to practice this very technique at home. They can do it and do it 20, 30 passes every day. And a lot of people have found this very useful for their digestion. So, I hope that these techniques have been of some use to you. And remember, practice well, but be always nicely in tune with your client. Communication of qi, of energy. And remember, you can do a lot of good therapeutic work without aggravating and without hurting. So from me, and can Marina say goodbye to them, please? Goodbye.